Hello, I'm Mr. Omniscient, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam of Allah, and not of Mullah, in Allah Islam, not in Shmullah Islam. Hardly anybody, these Mohammedan, if you ask them, what is the difference between Inshallah and Inshmullah? Inshallah, they will tell you they are going by the will of Allah. Inshmullah, oh, we don't know. This is not in Arabic. It's a strange word. The same inch mean willing, mullah mean mullah be willing. That means fatwa. So you can see so many hypocrisy in this world. And people are exposing the morality of people, not the hypocrisy. To expose the morality, so to downgrade a person, people are hiring people to make film and all that. And there is one of a journeyman who is trying to expose the morality of our brother Assange, a man of God, who exposed hypocrites. He brings us the hidden treasures of hypocrites, because in God we worship Him in truth. Truth means what is inside is outside. We don't tell lie, and in spirit, no hypocrisy. Like a little child, what is inside is outside. No double role. Politicians are number one hypocrites. And they are being exposed by Assange. And now they are trying to nab him for exposing them. And they are catching on excuses like morality and this and that. But morality, the sting of morality had been taken off in Jesus. John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16, he was the last prophet. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. And no more law, no more sin, no more morality. Simple as that. But hypocrisy comes. It is the age of Holy Spirit. Transgression against the Holy Spirit is hypocrisy. And that is more important and carry more weight than immorality. This Jesus demonstrated. Here I have written something. I, brethren, you are just like the satanic Judah tribe Jews of Jerusalem, who accused a woman of adultery and wanted to kill her. It's in John 8. Earlier, you know, they bring a woman to asking, hey, you are calling yourself big man, Jesus. Do the justice. Because he belonged to our supernatural father, so he was greater than John the Baptist, greater than the moral teachers. So are we. In Holy Spirit, we are greater than these morality, moral issues. They brought her to Jesus for justice, and our Omniscient, anointed brother, wrote down the sins of the sinners who were accusing her. Each one overlooked, and he was shocked. Then Jesus told them to throw the stone if they themselves are not sinners. All went away. These people who are accusing a man of God, Assange, who has exposed the evil thoughts of hypocrites for sex and all that is nothing but against their hypocrisies against Holy Spirit. So they are, you know, exposing his sex, you know, life and all that, that he had sex with this girl, that girl. That is next to nothing. In Jesus, is the transgression against the Holy Spirit that counts, and that is hypocrisy. Hypocrites, politicians are number one hypocrites. So hypocrisy is exposed by his word or by the honest people. So honest people are of God, whereas the dishonest people, crook, who make money, they are of Satan. So here is a journeyman who is making a film, you know, this has made a film and they just was showing the trailer. And when he made the film to expose the moral life of Assange, he was paid money. He did not do it free. In God, we do it free. When we expose the hypocrisy, we don't charge money. We carry our own cross of affliction. So these people who are accusing a man of God, Assange, who has exposed the evil thoughts of hypocrites, they are accusing him of for sex, you know, and all that is nothing but against their hypocrisies. When you weigh it against their hypocrisy, against Holy Spirit, is more important than the sins. That is why Jesus told the Jews inside their temple, John 8 verse 44, that their forefathers were liar, super bastard, fanatic devils. To this they retorted, you know, we are not born of illegitimate parents, we are not born of fornication. We have born of proper parents. Jesus said, what you say is true, but when you became Jew outwardly, then you say bye-bye to your tribal, Judah tribal father, because this is the tribal self. Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual self, not outwardly. Not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, because it's a spiritual self. People of Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, they died. They were born, they died during the Holocaust. So the knowledge of theology is so poor. I asked the dean of the Oxford University some years ago, who died on the cross, Jesus or Christ? He said, personally, if you ask me, it was Jesus who died. But officially, I can't say. That means they don't know the difference between Jesus and Christ. Christ is title. Jesus is the name. Is as simple as that, which ordinary man knows. And they are the dean, and they are issuing degrees to the students. What type of students would be that? Super blind professors leading the blind into the pit of sectarian riots. They are to be blamed for all the sectarian riots in the world. Ordinary people is not to be blamed. They create them with so-called priest, and then they create the blind following. So John 8, that their forefathers were liars, super pastors, fanatic devils. The Satanic Jews wanted to stone him, but he escaped as his time has not come. That is how people get angry when their hypocrisy is exposed in gospel truth. These Mohammedans, so-called Muslim, you know, they are not Muslim, they are infidels. A true Musliman, he has conscience, which we call hijab, and he is conscience, truthful, contented, and merciful. Such a person, he is in Allah, Allah is in him. He is a Musliman. Not those people who have no conscience, and they are liar, they are infidel. They usurp the right of others. As is written, you know, to take the property of a kafir. They proclaim somebody a kafir and take his property. So why you are taking his property is not yours. So you are kafir, you know, you are taking somebody's property. So people don't understand, but they just go by what the other people tell them to say. These Mohammedans kill a woman for adultery, but they themselves, by becoming a Mohammedan of flesh, outwardly, like Jews, you know, who became super bastard, they become super bastard fanatic devils as they kill a woman, a counterpart of Allah in providing life. Remember, in procreation, woman supply the blood, man supply the water. So woman is counterpart of Allah, because life is in the blood, not in the flesh. So they kill her, you know, and they themselves are super bastards. A counterpart of Allah in providing life. Life-giving gospel is for the twice-born people of Holy Spirit, common sense, and not for these fanatic, super bastard fanatic devils. Super bastard devils. Take for example, circumcision was the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only and not to Ishmael. So only the sons born of the seed of Isaac would be circumcised and not these white Aryans, Europeans, or Negroes. They are getting circumcised. If they get themselves circumcised, they become the sons of Abraham. But Abraham was of Semitic race. They are not of Semitic race. You can't change your father. So they become super bastards. These were created by the greedy temple priests to make their prey Jews. So they will, if they catch a prey, you know, then they say, oh, get yourself circumcised and you will become a Jew. You don't become Jew by circumcision of the flesh, it is circumcision of the heart. Because a Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. So, circumcised are not these white Aryans, European, by taking circumcision outside the seed of Isaac, you become a super bastard fanatic devil. These were created by the greedy temple priests to make their praise Jews outwardly, the fanatic super bastards. Stephen, angel Stephen, you know, he was angel. He was the moral teacher, like John the Baptist. Angel Stephen warned them against this malpractice. He told them when he gave the great speech that our forefather Abraham was a noble man. So don't make fake sons of Abraham. Keep his nobility. But they were making business out of this circumcision. So Angel Stephen warned them against this malpractice for the sake of greed, but they killed him. Today these fake sons of Isaac from Iran, India, Pakistan, then Negro, you know, all these people, etc., are going to kill them in May 2023. Through the atomic war, when atomic war is expected in May 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. That is, you reap the crop that you yourself have sown. Blaming not a third person. As Nanak said, you know, Nanak second coming of Jesus said, Dadda dosh na dijiye, dosh karmi apnea. Jo main kiya, so main paya, dosh na dijiye, avarjana. That means don't blame a third person. Whatever you have sown, you have reaped. So you can't blame a third person. During in 1947, my father was warning them, people, don't make Sikh as your tribe. Sikh is a community. And so is Muslim a community. So stay tribal people, like of my tribe is Jat. So he was telling them to stay tribal people and don't change the tribes by the religious selves, Hindu, Sikh or Muslim. You will die. And that's what happened, you know. So do well to others and reap well. Preach gospel truth and have the protection of our Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. They are the same thing, you know. They are the supernatural Father, our supernatural Father, you know. Much more in my YouTube video channel, Nijjar One. So if you go to my channel, you will find a lot of videos on gospel truth. Gospel truth is by grace. Not everybody can have it. So if you long for gospel, then you get it. Otherwise, you won't get it. So you must have a desire for gospel. Then gospel will be, you will be seeking, and then you will be getting it. Gospel is not something you can read. It is inside you here. It's not, cannot be written down in ink on paper, because you have to brew it through logical reasoning. Logical reasoning you have to do yourself, not somebody else going to do for you. So you have to learn how to do logically, think logically, and do things logically, and then you will get gospel truth in your heart. It cannot be written on an ink on paper.